recently updated. I believe the HA has such a mechanism in place.
Members' motions. We now continue the debate on the motion under the Legislative Council Powers and Privileges Ordinance. Does any member wish to speak? Secretary for Constitutional and Mainland Affairs.
President, on last Wednesday, many members spoke on this motion. Let me respond to them generally. First of all, we attach importance to privacy, and in this incident involving the loss of computers, we would follow up seriously. As the Deputy Undersecretary said last time, we understand that there are shortcomings in the arrangement by the REO, and therefore there's a case to investigate and review the situation so as to make improvements and prevent recurrence. For the inconvenience and distress caused by this incident to the public, I have repeatedly offered sincere apologies to the public on behalf of REO. But I do not agree the government, the SAL government, is trying to hide something, or we are trying to deny our responsibility. On the contrary, after the loss of the two portable computers, a number of follow-up actions were triggered. On the very same night, after the loss was reported to the Bureau, we issued a press release to inform the public. And I also took the initiative to contact the Constitutional Affairs Panel to convene a special meeting so as to give an account to the public openly. Since this is a criminal case, members should understand that it would not be appropriate for me to disclose details of criminal investigation at this stage. But on the 11th of April, at the CA panel meeting, we already announced the information that we had grabs, and also we reported on the follow-up action taken by the REO. President, an interdepartmental task force has been set up involving OGCIO, my bureau, and relevant colleagues from the Security Bureau. They have been working since April. With the participation of these colleagues, the impartiality of the work of the task force can be ensured, and the task force will be able to look into the causes of this incident and also to further review the procedures adopted by the REO so that shortcomings can be identified and improvements made. We promised to the Constitutional Affairs Panel that on the 19th of June at the panel meeting, we would report back to members on the review findings and recommendations. President, let me stress again that apart from the study carried out by the task force going on in earnest, there are other investigations, including the police criminal investigation and a formal investigation by the privacy commissioner. Both have not yet been completed, and the REO will in 3 months' time, and that is before the middle of June, submit an election report to the CE. Before these reports are ready, before the report is submitted, we think that it would neither be necessary nor appropriate for this council to set up a select committee to look into the matter. Once again, I urge members to vote against Dr. Chen Chung-tai's motion, so I submit.
I now call upon Dr. Honorable Zhang Chung-tai to reply. The debate will come to a close after Dr. Zhang has replied. Dr. Zhang. Madam Deputy, the REO has lost information of all electors in Hong Kong. It's not that the privacy of the electors has been undermined. It also hurts the election system of Hong Kong as a whole. In my speech last week, I said that that it has to do with the trust between the government of Hong Kong and Hong Kong people. We count on election system to ascertain the identity of Hong Kong people, and the government's treating voters' information in such a way, and that undermines the trust between Hong Kong people and Hong Kong government. So we need a more transparent and fair and just mechanism to do investigation. We have to look into whether certain government officials have a dereliction of duty on their part. So I hope that the members can support my motion to establish a select committee to look into this incident of loss of data of electors. So I speak. And I put the question to you that the motion moved by Cheng Chung-tai be passed. Will those, Dr. Helena Wong, ask for a division? The division bell will ring for 5 minutes. Thank you. Voting begins. Please check your vote. If there is no question, voting is closed. Display of results. From FCs, 26 present, 6 for, 19 against. From GCs, 26 present, 15 for, 11 against. I think the question is not agreed by majority of each of the two groups of members. I declare the motion negatived. Debate on motion with no legislative effect.